Yeah. I'm back to filming. Hi.
Hey, hi.
Hi.
Bye.
There you go, hon. Here's the ozone room.
Oh. Going on a tour. Cody, if you want, you can hold on to the
reel.
Get some exercise today. It's okay. I'm filming though. Be careful, watch your head.
Watch out for that yellow line again.
Yeah, don't look at the yellow line. Cody. Yeah, but don't go past it. Hi.
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 All right, good morning, everyone. My name is Collier. I'm one of the senior aquarists here at Manta. I'm going to try to talk as loud and clear as I can. If you can't hear anything, I'll be happy to.
Don't go past that line, okay?
And then I'm going to save some time for questions at the end. So if you have any questions about SeaWorld or a rescue program or here or how I got my job, whatever it is, I'll be happy to try and answer. But welcome to Manta. This is our
main exhibit.
We've gone M2. M is Manta. 2 is the second aquarium in the exhibit. 240,000 gallons of salt water that we make here in-house. It's met the same conditions that you would find natural seawater. It's home to a very vast array of different
labyrinths.
If you don't know, labyrinths are sharks, skates, and crates. So one of our most unique in this exhibit, as you can see, it's swimming around really fast. You might even see them jump out of the water. It's our lesser devil rays. Now, lesser devil rays are the much smaller cousins of manta rays. We're very lucky to work with them. A lot of aquariums don't get this chance. The couple of unique characteristics about our lesser devil rays, they don't have barbs like their stingray cousins, and they're also filter feeders. So that means that they swim through big schools of fish eggs and shrimp, and they put down loads and create a funnel, swim through a cloud of stuff really quick, and then they digest that. Now you might be thinking to yourself, how the heck do you feed them, if that's what they do here, and make sure that they get the appropriate amount of food? Well, the way we do that here is we use a bottle just like this. We fill this bottle with different types of krill, which is small shrimp. We fill it with pellets so that they get a better nutritional value. Sometimes we can put B vitamins or iodine supplements, whatever we might need to give them. And we condition these animals, we work with them, to come up to the bottle, lower their, put their load down, create a funnel, they latch onto it, and as they're swimming by, we can feed them. We squeeze the krill into their mouth. There's a couple benefits to this for us and for them. I think the biggest benefit for them is they get a great mouthful of food that they love. But for us, it helps us keep an eye on our animals. We don't get the opportunity like maybe a killer whale trainer or somebody that works with our sea lions to have a colony all over, touch them, deal with them, but our animals need to be in the water. And so the way that we get our looks at them is by feeding them. So we can say, okay, we know all of our males are getting the appropriate amount of food they need. We can look at their, there you go. I'll get to that in just a second. We know that all of our animals are getting the right amount of food. We know that their gills look great, their eyes look great, their skin condition is great. So what just happened here, this is another characteristic of this particular ray. In the wild, they live off the coast of Florida. You can go to Tampa and see them in the beaches there. They jump out of the water like that, and there's a lot of theories as to why they do this, but we're not exactly sure. A couple theories are they're running from predators. Here, they're obviously not doing that. Another is they're knocking parasites off them, so external parasites. Now, here, our animals don't have external parasites. They go through a very, they go through a quarantine process, basically, to make sure that they don't have any. Another, what we think is going on, is that they might be mating. It might be some sort of mating ritual or display. Look how high I can jump out of the water, come be my boyfriend kind of thing, I don't know. But they're, like I said, they're very unique. When we first got them, they started doing that. It was kind of like, oh my gosh! But our bonnet heads, they'll kind of, what we call spy hop. They'll hop out of the water and look at us and kind of wave. Or, you know, after our big leopard ray, he'll come up and make a big splash. So I want to save some time for questions. Do you have any questions for me?
What kind of
designated for males and females are always mixed together. In this particular exhibit, yes they are, there are certain animals in here that are very successful with mating. In particular, our bonnethead sharks. Our bonnethead sharks, we actually just had pups a couple days ago.